This bill was read for the first time in this hallowed chamber on Wednesday, 5th May, 2021. The bill seeks to provide for the accelerated development of the Nigerian solid mineral sector so as to diversify the Nigerian economy and reduce the over-dependence on the dwindling oil revenues. I made bold to say that Nigeria is richly endowed with a variety of solid minerals of various categories, ranging from precious metals to various precious stones and industrial minerals. The Nigerian Extractive Industries and Transparency Initiative, NAITI, reported that there are approximately 40 different kinds of solid minerals and precious metals buried in Nigeria's soil waiting to be exploited. The sector offers a viable alternative to petroleum for foreign exchange earnings. Globally, the mining industry has been a close rival to the petroleum industry. While Nigeria only earns a paltry sum of $89 million per annum from it, the commercial value of Nigerian solid minerals has been estimated to run into hundreds of billions of dollars. The objective of this bill includes, but not limited to, one, formulation of policies and guidelines for the development of the mineral producing areas. Two, conceptions, planning, and implementation in accordance with set rules and regulations of projects and programs for sustainable development of the minerals producing areas in the field of transportation, including roads, health, employment, industrialization, agri and fisheries, housing and urban development, water supply, electricity, and telecommunications. Three, surveying the minerals producing area in order to ascertain measures necessary to promote its physical and socio-economic development. Four, preparing master plans and schemes designed to promote the physical development of the minerals producing areas and the estimation of the member states of the Commission. And five, implementation of all the measures approved for the development of the minerals producing areas by the federal government and the member states of the Commission. The mining sector is responsible for some of the largest releases of heavy metals into the environment of any industry. It also releases other air pollutions of waste, tailing slugs, and acid drainage. Occupational and environmental exposure to heavy metals, silica, and asbestos can occur during mining and milling operations. The smelting process, extracting the metal from the ore, is associated with the highest exposures and environmental releases. The hazard to human health caused by exposure to heavy metals, including lead, calcium, and mercury, have been thoroughly documented by experts. These metals are associated with a range of neurological deficits in both children and adults, in addition to a range of other systemic effects. Exposure to airborne silica and asbestos can cause lung cancer, pneumoconiosis, and numerous other health effects. More commonly, small-scale gold mining utilizes significant quantities of mercury to extract gold from the ore. Exposure to mercury in these operations not only endangers miners and their families, but is also detrimental to the environment when deposited in the water supply, which cannot be avoided. Artisanal gold mining employs an estimated 10 to 15 million miners in more than 55 countries. Estimates are that these small operations produce about 20% of the world's gold supply. According to the United Nations Environmental Program, UNEP, small-scale gold processing operations in developing countries employ 1 million children, children who are more susceptible to the impacts of heavy metals, tend to have higher exposures, and generally account for the majority of deaths and diseases associated with mass poisoning incidents from these operations. Studies have documented that children involved in mining have exposures to mercury, lead, and other metals and suffer severe lead and mercury intoxication. Mining is an inherently invasive process that can cause damage to a landscape in an area much larger than the mining site itself. The effect of this damage can continue years after a mine has shut down, including the addition to greenhouse gases, death of flora and fauna, and erosion of lands and habitats. Most modern mining techniques have high water demands for extraction, processing, and waste disposal. Waste water from these processes can pollute water sources nearby and deplete fresh water supplies in regions surrounding areas near the mines. Thus, the need for a special agency to cushion in this effect of the environmental degradation, which affects farming and other activities in most mining areas, as can be visibly seen in many mining sites across Nigeria. In line with our other 77, top 73, the compendium of financial implications is hereby attacked. I thank you, Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, for your attention, and therefore solicit your support for the second reading of this bill. I so submit, Mr. President.
Is anybody against the bill? Those in favor that this bill be now read a second time, say aye. Those against, say nay. The ayes have it. A bill for an act to establish the Solid Minerals Producing Areas Development Commission in the Federal Republic of Nigeria to address the environmental devastation and for other connected matters there to 2021 second reading taken, and the bill is referred to the Committee on Solid Minerals to report back within 4 weeks. Thank you very much. Leader of the